Hi guys, it's Anissa. Welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm going to be doing another makeup haul for you guys. This is only the first part of this video. This part is being filmed a little bit earlier than the second part. I haven't got all my packages in yet, but I'm sick and tired of letting this makeup sit here and not be opened. Don't want it to feel neglected. If you guys like this video, make sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe. I post on this channel every 4 days, so you never have to miss me for too long. If you like hauls, lucky for you, I have a whole playlist of hauls that I will link right up here for you guys to check out after you watch this video. We have Dose of Colors, ColourPop, Lunar Beauty, Hailey's Beauty, Patrick Ta. We got all of it. Let's go ahead and get into it. First package is from Ulta. I wanted to tell you guys, most of this makeup actually was from Cyber Monday / Black Friday. And then some of the makeup I ordered after, because some websites will have a Black Friday, Cyber Monday sale, and then like 3 weeks later have an even bigger sale. So like Hailey's Beauty, they only had 30% off for Cyber Monday. And then this week, which is the beginning of December, they had 50% off. I went ahead and ordered two ColourPop eyeshadow palettes on Ulta Beauty because when I ordered off of ColourPop, they were out of these eyeshadow palettes and I've been eyeing these for a while. This first one has gorgeous packaging. This is the ColourPop Good as Gold. Over the past 2 weeks, I have really been reaching for this ColourPop California Love palette. It has slowly become one of my favorite drugstore eyeshadow palettes. My Ulta does not have a very big selection of ColourPop palettes, so I went ahead and went online and ordered a whole bunch. This is what it looks like. So definitely more yellow golds in here, which I usually don't go for. Very much Bumblebee vibes to me. So I'm very excited. We do have one pressed glitter, it looks like. This next palette, I have waited over a year to try, so she better not disappoint. Bare Necessities Pressed Powder Palette. And this is actually a lot smaller than I thought it was gonna be. I figured that it would be like the size of a Morphe palette, but it's actually a little bit smaller. This is honestly a lot more cool toned than it looked online, which I'm honestly really not mad about, because I really don't have a whole lot of cool tones. I'm a warm type of gal. Never tried them, but I've always in my mind thought that they wouldn't look good on me, but I think I'm finally gonna be brave and just try them. This is from Sephora, and I know exactly what this is. And the only reason that I even ordered this was because every time I went in store to get this product, it was sold out. This is such gorgeous packaging. I don't know if you guys will be able to read it or not, but this is the Patrick Ta Major Headlines Blush Palette. Patrick Ta is by far one of my favorite cream blush and powder blush formulas. It's just so buildable and pigmented and creamy. So when I saw that they were coming out with a palette, I was like, I don't even care if it's limited edition, because I really try to stay away from limited edition stuff unless it's something that I know that I'm already gonna like. Look at how gorgeous that is. These colors right here, I feel like can double as bronzers and blushes. And then I don't have anything like these two colors. He never comes to play with the packaging. Y'all already knew that though. Next, we have this big box, and it says that this is from Alamar Cosmetics. During the Black Friday Cyber Monday sale, I really try to take advantage of websites that I can't get my hands on in person. Not that I don't already have enough makeup bags. I must have got this for free. Just a cute little purple clear makeup bag. First, I have a highlighter in here. The Sun-Soaked Highlighter, La Playa. Ooh, okay, this is gorgeous. This is what the color looks like. I wanna go ahead and swatch that. She is gorgeous. This is what it looks like on the finger. I'm excited to try that, and I've never heard anybody talk about that. I went ahead and picked up two lip liners. These are the Dos Nudas, and these are the long-wearing lip liners. I got the colors Deep Olive Brown and Warm Chocolate Brown. I like the packaging on those. That's very pretty. These are so creamy. I believe Alamar is a Hispanic brand. On here, it looks like the names are Divina and Coqueta. Hopefully I said that right. This color is Divina, and this is Coqueta. So this is like a true brown, and then this is more of like a reddish brown. Y'all know I love a good brown lip liner. If I can give y'all options, I'm gonna give you options. I got one more lip product. Ooh, this packaging is cute. Desnudas lip gloss. I got the color Divina. So I want to go ahead and swatch this. Oh my gosh. Look at how pigmented that is. This is like the most pigmented lip gloss I've ever seen. It looks like a really wet liquid lipstick because of how pigmented it is. I also wanted to try the eye primer. This is the Piero Primero Primer, and it's a long wear sticky pigment base. Lastly, but definitely not least, because this is the whole reason I even went on the website, because I knew that I was gonna buy this no matter what. Colorette Blush Trio, and this is the one in Dark Rich. These are what the colors look like. So you have a variety. I feel like I'm really not gonna like this light pink one because it's pretty shimmer / glitter heavy, but the other two don't seem to have as much shimmer and glitter in them, so that'll be interesting. These are the swatches. I'm surprised at how pigmented this light pink is. That was it from Alamar. I actually wanna go through this Target bag because if you watched my last haul, you would know that I lost this bag and it ended up that my friend had it. This is a repurchase. This is the Wet n Wild makeup sponge. Love, love, love these. They're so super soft and I actually like this shape better than the original Beauty Blender shape because it's a teardrop but it has a slant on the side so you have a bigger surface for underneath the eye. I accidentally bought this product for the second time. This is the Arches and Halos Micro Defining Brow Pencil and this is in the color Espresso. I thought that I had the color dark brown. I didn't think that I had Espresso but I do already have Espresso in the pencil, but I don't have Espresso in the pomade. I have a backup of this and luckily I like it. I also went ahead and got this Arches and Halos Water Resistant Firm Hold Brow Gel and this is in the color clear. I have only ever used the Juvia's Place Brow Gel, which is what I've been using every day because it's the only thing that I have. So I want to use something else that way I can compare to see if I really like the Juvia's Place. I feel like if you've only ever tried one of something, you don't really have anything to compare it to. So I'm excited to try this. This is a mini of the Verst Day Dissolve Cleansing Balm. It's supposed to have eucalyptus oil and vitamin E in it. Such a sucker for like eucalyptus, peppermint, tea tree oil because it just feels so good and tingly on the skin. This is also a repurchase that I emptied a long time ago. This is the Maybelline Superstay Full Coverage Foundation and I have the color 355 Coconut. This stuff is medium to full coverage, has a matte finish and your makeup is not going to go anywhere all day. I had this for maybe 2 months and then emptied it out. Undone Beauty and I've only been able to find this brand at Target but this is their lip to cheek palette and this is in the color 340 Rosewood. This is technically a repurchase but just in a different color. These are the e.l.f. Bite Size eyeshadows and I had never seen this color palette. This is in the color Truffle so you have like really nice transition shades and then a really pretty shimmer shade. Definitely one of my favorite affordable drugstore eyeshadow formulas. I have been really into using primer mist before my makeup ever since it has gotten colder outside so I wanted to go ahead and try this e.l.f. Hydrating Coconut Mist to hydrate skin and refresh makeup. All of the primer mists and sprays that I tried from e.l.f. I've really, really liked. These are also repurchases, just I don't have these two colors, liquid, metallic, and glitter eyeshadows, and I have the color Meteor and Ocean Eyes. I love using these liquid eyeshadows as toppers to pop in the center of my eyelid. I haven't even tried the Stila liquid eyeshadows, and I have no desire to because these are just so good. These are what the swatches look like. I am so, so excited to use this blue. Formula is so super creamy. Went ahead and bought another eyeshadow brush, Sonia Kashuk Medium Blending Brush. This is what it looks like. I thought that this would be perfect for like packing color into the outer crease. I really have become a big fan of Sonia Kashuk brushes over the last year. They are a little bit more expensive and I feel like you can get pretty much the same quality with e.l.f. and Real Techniques, but if you're just wanting to try something different, I do definitely recommend Sonia Kashuk. Lastly, we have a skincare product, Neutrogena City Shield Water Gel Sunscreen. I do wear sunscreen year round. With me doing my makeup more often the past couple months, I found that I really do not like lotion texture products on my face. Feel like they are way too heavy. So I was like, I wonder if they make like a gel sunscreen or a water gel sunscreen. And then I found this and it's from the Hydro Boost line, which is one of my favorites. So I'm actually going on vacation tomorrow. So I will be taking this with me. I always say if you have more combo slash oily skin, try a more gel based moisturizer. It will change your life. Next is Dose of Colors. I've actually never tried anything from Dose of Colors, but I've heard very good things. I'm kind of nervous to open this because I had to take a really good guess on my shades for the foundation. It's like always that moment of truth, knowing if you're gonna get a good shade or not. First thing I got in here are two different beauty sponges. Got the jumbo one and then the regular size one. They feel pretty soft. They're not even like a teardrop shape. They're more of like a cone shape. So this is the regular one and this is the jumbo one. Picked up two of their liquid lipsticks. I got the colors Heartbreaker and Core. Pretty sure that their liquid lipsticks are what made them well known. This right here is the color Cork and this is the color Heartbreaker. Very, very creamy, thin formulas that are also really pigmented. When I was going to buy these, you wouldn't believe the amount of websites I went on to look at swatches because I'm telling you guys, it's the one thing that I hate about shopping for makeup online is that depending on the lighting you're in, I guess this happens when you're in person too, but depending on the light that they shoot the swatches in, in will kind of make the color really deceiving. Lastly, I just went ahead and picked up the foundation and concealer. In the concealer, I got the color 22 dark, and then in the foundation, I got the color 130 dark. This is what the concealer looks like. I actually think that that color is going to be perfect for me. I love my under eyes to be bright. That concealer does claim to be full coverage. This foundation claims to be medium to full coverage. Oh my gosh, this bottle is huge. Comes in a bottle with a matte glass finish. So I'm gonna go ahead and pump some out. No way did I get this lucky. Okay, so that's the shade, which I think I can make work. I was hoping, if anything, that it would be darker because I do have those LA Girl mixing pigments that I can just make it lighter with, but I actually think that this is gonna end up being perfect. I'm really happy about that because I used to have the worst luck with that. I hate returning stuff, whether it's in person or online, but especially when it's online, and then waiting, like me having to send it to them, and then sending me my right shade, it's just a hassle. So I would rather pane through and make it work and finish the product and then get my right shade. I feel like I've just had so many bad experiences with customer service that I'm just like, I don't want anything to even do with them. Next we have ColourPop. Individually bubble wrap everything. Wild Child palette. This component is so nice for how affordable this is. It looks better in person than it did online. This middle shade right here is what drew me in because I have nothing like that color. So I'm excited to play with that. I know that I got a whole bunch of these little quads, so I'm just gonna show you guys them all at the same time. Stuff like this is so perfect for travel. This first one is the Down to Earth quad, Free to Be, and I actually like the components on these too. They're very unique, completely clear on the back and the front. Dare to Bear, So Au Naturel, Bear It All, and lastly this one is Sheath a Naturel. I was so intrigued by these because A, they're so perfect for travel, and B, if you're somebody that gets like very overwhelmed by having to pick colors from a like 24 shade eyeshadow palette, this is literally so easy because it gives you the colors that you need to complete one look. I like glitter or shimmer on my lid always. So what I would do is I would just use one of these or maybe a couple of them and mix and match, and then just use like a little single eyeshadow and call it a day. I think that I got all six of these because they had them like in a bundle and I was just gonna get three or four of them, but it was just a better deal to get all six of them. I've also been eyeing their little 5-pan eyeshadow palettes for a while. This is what they look like up close. This top one is Crush, and then the bottom one is Lyric. So something a little bit more warm and sunset vibes, and then you got something definitely more smoky. I am really impressed. I've never really like been able to feel or see a lot of ColourPop eyeshadow palette components, and these are actually very nice feeling for how affordable these are. I forgot about this little one. This is the Sparkler Pressed Powder Palette. Oh my gosh, these two shimmers right there. Next is BH Cosmetics. Only things that I have tried from BH Cosmetics are a blush palette that was too light for me, and I've also tried highlighter palette that I really like, but my Ulta does not sell any of their brushes. I think that I got these brushes like 80% off or something. I have tried the Glowing in Grease blush palette, I believe, and the formula was nice on it, but it was just way too light for me. I saw this one online, and now that I'm seeing it in person, I think that this is gonna work a lot better for me. Weekend Vibes Bellini palette, and this is what the colors look like. I think this color is gonna be a little bit too light, but I knew that I could probably make these five work, and I wanna see if this is Color Girl friendly. I've never seen anybody talk about this, and I'm hoping that the shade that I picked is okay. BH Studio Pro Matte Finish Pressed Powder, and I picked the color 250. It's always so hard to tell by just looking at even pan pictures and even in person because it looks so different in the pan than it does on your face, I found with powder foundations, but I think that I can make that work. It has a really velvety formula. I probably sound like a broken record at this point if you have watched my videos before, but if you haven't, when you're picking out a powder foundation shade, whether you're darker than me or lighter than me, the color in the pan is not going to be exactly what it looks like on your face 9 times out of 10. It usually will be a little bit darker. And I also got the shade 240, which I know that this is gonna be too light, but I may be able to use this underneath the eyes. Also got another blush palette. This is the Essential Blush 10 color blusher palette. And now that I'm looking at these shades in person, they didn't look like this on the website. Not that they're bad or anything, but I mean like pretty much all these shades look exactly the same, and then you have this darker one over here. I may end up giving this away in a giveaway or something. Small packer brush, and I thought that this would be nice for if I ever wanted to do a halo eye and just place a color very precisely in the center of my lid. Rounded face brush, and this is supposed to be for liquid foundation. It's so weird. I can usually tell by feeling if I'm gonna like something for cream or powder, and these brushes feel a little bit more synthetic. I feel like I'm not gonna love this for liquid foundation, but I could so be wrong because sometimes I am. Tapered setting brush, and I thought that this would be good for highlighter or even setting underneath the eyes. Dense cheek brush, and this is supposed to be for like contour or blush, but I'm so excited to try this because I don't really have anything this shape. So it's a little bit wider and thinner, but then it's kind of rounded at the top. Dense primer brush, and I don't know what I got this for. Maybe I got this for my eyelid, but I don't do a nose contour. And that's really the only small part of my face that I could see myself using this for. Domed pencil brush, and I thought that this would be good for like smudging out the lower lash line or packing color into my outer crease. BH liquid eyeliner in the color black. Has a felt tip. Let's see what the pigmentation. Oh my gosh. I barely had to press. And that was so, so black. So I'm excited to try this. I get so excited when I try products that I don't hear a lot of other people talk about, and then they end up being really good. And I'm like, why is nobody talking about this? I'm always on the hunt for a good brow pencil. So this is the dual-ended precision pencil, and I got this in the color ebony. This is the first brush set that I got. This is the Marble Luxe 10-piece brush set. The handles on these are so nice, and these feel so weighted. Lastly, I have the Midnight Festival brush set. It's a little makeup brush holder that is bright pink. I've honestly never really been one to be super particular about the packaging of my brushes, but I'm telling you, these brushes are like the prettiest brushes I have ever seen. I only have one more box for today, and this is from Lunar Beauty. I have been eyeing one of these products for quite a while, and then the other one was really just an impulsive buy. Lunar Beauty Moom Prism Blush Cheek Palette. And if you guys did not know, Lunar Beauty is owned by Manny MUA, who, let me just say, not only do I think he's so talented, but he is so funny. The front of this packaging is like 3D. It pops out. The little moons do. I'm kind of disappointed because these colors are a little bit paler than what I thought they were gonna be. I'm just gonna try this right now because if not, I'm just gonna send it right back. I wanna go ahead and try these two colors right here. These seem the darkest. I'm actually gonna mix a little bit of this bright pink in right here too. Ooh. Oh, wow. And that actually shows up. I was a little afraid that it wasn't going to, but you can tell that this cheek has more pink on it. Ooh. Okay, I actually like that. I like to try to utilize the lighter colors by mixing them with more dark shades. Lunar Beauty Life's a Drag Facelift. The reason that I bought this is because I have been looking for a palette that includes color but also has very wearable shades in it, because I feel like palettes with this type of color scheme are so perfect for people who want to play with color but also want to do a more nude look. This is what the color palette looks like. All right, guys, that is the first portion of this video, so you guys will see me here in a couple seconds. For me, it'll be like a week and a half, but you will see me in a couple seconds with the second half of this video. Hi, it's me from a week later. I finally got the last four packages so we can finally finish up this haul. I'm gonna go ahead and start with the two biggest boxes, the first one being from e.l.f. I think I'm actually going to do like a full face using e.l.f. makeup, so that's where you guys are gonna see a lot of this makeup, so stay tuned for that video. I'm gonna go ahead and start with my repurchases, things that I have bought backups of, multiples of, and then we'll get into the new stuff. This one I'm the most excited to talk to you guys about because they actually discontinued it for a little bit, but they have finally bought it back. E.l.f. Total Face Sponge Marshmallow Blender. You need to listen to me on this one. This is the softest beauty sponge I have ever used. It's the same shape as the Real Techniques sponge and the original E.l.f. Total Face Sponge. I bought one of these and I kind of just bought it on a whim and I tried it. Oh my gosh, I probably had that for like a year. And then when I went to recommend it to you guys, it was limited edition. They didn't sell it anymore, but they have finally bought it back. So I'm super excited because you guys can finally get these. And I actually specifically talked about this in my makeup brushes that I can't live without video. If you're somebody like me who prefers a really, really soft sponge, you're gonna love this. Had to buy backups of my e.l.f. Line and Define eye tapes. I'm on my second pack right now. And when I ran out of my first pack, I went to go order a second pack. Keep in mind, each of these are only $3, but they were completely sold out. So I had to pay $15 for one pack of these on Amazon. They are so worth the money that I would pay $15 for them, but it's just the principle that they are originally $3 and I had to pay $15 for them. I decided to go ahead and buy two. I just opened my new pack, but I have a fear of running out of these again and having to pay that much for them. These are absolutely amazing for anybody who has a really shaky hand like me and you still want to be able to get a nice crisp eyeliner. Perfect example. The wings on my eyes right now are from using the Elf Line and Fine Eye Tapes. You get 40 strips. If you cut them in half, they last twice as long. They came out with new color schemes for the Elf Bite Size eyeshadows, and you guys actually have already seen this one earlier in the video. This is the truffle one. I actually bought this one from Target and wasn't sure. I couldn't remember if I had or hadn't. And I was like, you know what? If I bought two of them, I'll just throw one of them in a giveaway or something like that. This one just has a bunch of good transition colors. This is in the shade I Love You a Latte. Just to show you guys, this is how many I have. Elf Wow Brow Volumizing Fiber Gel, and this is in the color Deep Brown. Elf makes my favorite drugstore eyebrow pencil, the Precise one, not the thick one, but the small one that comes in the black packaging. I got a free eyeshadow palette that I honestly probably will not use because I have so many shades like this. Giving this away to you guys too when we hit 1,000 subscribers. Mad for Matte eyeshadow palette. Stardust Glitter Eyeliner, and this is in the color Shimmering Gold. It looks gorgeous from the outside. Adding a little bit of detail to the crease. This is what the swatch looks like, so you definitely get a good amount of pigment. It's a very, very pretty yellowish type of gold. The blue topper that I have on my lid is actually a e.l.f. glitter eyeshadow. Finally caved, and I wanted to go ahead and try one of these buffing brushes, oval large complexion brush. Do you guys remember when these first came out 5 or 6 years ago? And I believe that the brand Artise is the one that came out with them, and it was like a big oval brush kit that was like $300 or $400. I definitely like bigger brushes for the face because it takes less time. I have never tried anything from this pink line from e.l.f. This is the e.l.f. matte oil control primer, and it's supposed to be clay infused cream eyeliner, and this is in the color Coffee. I love their e.l.f. brow cream and liner as a pomade, and I recently just tried my first gel liner, and I really, really liked it. I found that gel liners are really awesome if you ever want to do a liner and then like smoke it out and make it look really like sultry. We only have one more face product, and then the rest is lips. I decided to pick up one of their liquid lipsticks. This is the e.l.f. liquid matte lipstick, and this is specifically in the color Coffee. Colors like these I love so, so much. They just have like the perfect mix of brown and pink in them. New lip stains, the glossy ones. So this one is in the color Basic Beige, this one's Power Mauve, and this one is Cinnamon Dream. The packaging is super, super cute. This is what the front looks like, and then in the back you can see what the colors look like. That is what the three colors look like, and they definitely do stain because I just wiped it off and you can still see. Love Triangle Lip Filler Liners, and I have the colors Mauve, Deep Brown, and Light Brown, and they are retractable. To be honest with you guys, the formula isn't super creamy. Mauve, Light Brown, and Deep Brown. They're definitely pigmented. The colors are showing up, but they're not the creamiest thing that I've ever tried. That could be because the formula looks to be a little bit more matte. Lastly, I went ahead and got a skincare item. I have seen a lot of stuff that I have been wanting to try from e.l.f. Skincare. I've been loving the eye cream, but I really want to try their gel moisturizer. And then I also came across this serum. So this is the e.l.f. Hydrating Serum. It has a pretty big bottle. We're gonna do the second biggest package, which is Beauty Creations. So it's a package and a package. If I could ever fit a full face of makeup into one of these, something this small, I don't know what I would do. In the bag, I got a little Ultra Dazzle lip gloss, and I got this in the color BFF. I will be putting this in a giveaway. I am gonna also be incorporating this makeup into a one brand tutorial because I have enough to do a full face. The main reason that I even ordered from them was because I wanted to try the foundation, Flawless Stay Foundation. It claims to have medium to full coverage, and I got the color FS9. Comes with a pump that is so cute, and it comes in a frosted glass bottle. That's the shade, so I think it's gonna be a little bit too light for me. I did just go on vacation, so I'm a little bit darker than what I usually am. So if anything, I'll just have to mix a little bit of another foundation into it. I also wanted to go ahead and try the concealer because it claims to be full coverage. Flawless Stay Concealer, C16 and C18. C18 and not C16. Oh my gosh, that is so, so light. Couple of brow products. Eyebrow Define Gel, and I got the color Ebony. Packaging is so cute. So that's what the packaging looks like. That color is gonna be perfect. Eyebrow Definer Pencil, and I got this in the color Dark Brown. I wanna show you guys this because this is exactly what I mean by breaking the seal on products. So over here, you see how it's a little bit lighter, but then when you get in the center, it's a little bit darker. So where it's lighter is where I first used the product and it hadn't been used at all. Some products will have like a cast on top of them where they dry at the top and the formula is actually like it changes because it's drier. Brow Tame Setting Gel. Look at how tiny the spoolie is on that. I think that's going to be awesome. I love when the spoolies are tinier, especially for people like me who don't have super thick, fluffy, full brows. They did have a beauty sponge. Usually I won't buy sponges online because I like to be able to feel them. It seems to be pretty soft. All we have left is a couple of palettes. Floral Bloom Highlight and Contour Palette. This is what it looks like. So excited to try these two eyeshadow palettes. The packaging on this is so beautiful. Frida eyeshadow palette. I think that this is inspired by Frida Kahlo. Oh my gosh. It's even more beautiful in person than it is online. My favorite colorful looks to do are more like purpley, reddish, pinkish type of colors, and that's literally what this screams. And you also do have a couple neutral colors. Then lastly, I got this one, and this is the Island Girl eyeshadow palette. What drew me into this palette was these blue tones over here. I really do not have a whole lot blue in my collection, and this palette in general reminds me of the Be Perfect Cosmetics palette. So I want to see if these colors are any good, because I've not found a good colorful affordable eyeshadow palette for you guys. So I would love to be able to recommend this. Those were my two biggest boxes. I only have two small ones left. This first one is from Hailey's Beauty. I actually just ran out of my primer, and I had actually not tried the new formula, but they have it on pre-order. So I bought two of them, but those aren't coming until February. I wanted to try their brushes. They don't have the names on them, but I'll go ahead and show them and put the name underneath both of them. So this is the first one. I think that this is the just domed kabuki brush. This one is the powder brush. I thought that this would be really good for bronzer. I also wanted to try their Refresh Ultimate Priming and Setting Spray. One of my favorite categories of makeup, if you guys cannot tell. These are all my primer sprays and setting sprays, so this will be added to the collection. Lastly, I wanted to go ahead and try their concealer because it also claims to be full coverage. Rewind Blurring Full Coverage Concealer. And this is in the color Tan Warm. It does have a really smooth formula. Ooh, okay, I think this color is gonna be perfect. One last product from Sephora that I am so excited to try. I was back and forth on if I was going to even get this because it is limited edition. New limited edition Tartlet Full Bloom Eyeshadow Palette. Tarte has some of my favorite eyeshadow formulas. They are so pigmented, so creamy, so smooth. Packaging is super nice. It's gold on the back, and then this is what the front looks like. So pretty. All right, guys, that is it for today's video. Just look out for this makeup to be in new upcoming videos. I'm so excited to try a bunch of this stuff for you guys and let you know what my thoughts are. If you guys have tried any of this makeup, please let me know down in the comments and what you thought of it. Or if you've thought about trying any of this makeup and you've had your eye on it, let me know what you are thinking about getting. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.